It can be easily argued that the Joker is the greatest villain in Batman's rogue gallery, haunting the character ever since his first appearance in Batman number 1 way back in 1940. Throughout the years, there have been many different interpretations of this character, from the cold-blooded gangster to the wacky clown prince to the Pale Man, the supposed horror of Gotham's history. The idea of an actual origin for this character has been played several times, with each origin being vastly different, something that the Dark Knight movie played off of with each story that Heath Ledger told about how he got his scars. He's gone from failed comedian to criminal mastermind. Then suddenly, everything changed. During the Darkseid War story arc in Justice League, Batman gained access to the Mobius chair. You see, this chair has the knowledge of everything in the entire universe, and he asked it a simple question: who is the Joker? He and us, the readers, gained an answer that we were not expecting. There are three Jokers. Since this reveal, fans have been clamoring for an answer while at the same time coming up with their own wild theories. Hopefully, we will have the answer soon, as Geoff Johns and Jason Fobok will be releasing a three-part miniseries titled The Three Jokers, finally giving us our answers to the series. But until then, let's go over some of those popular theories and then knock out one of our own. Now, number one is that there are a literal three Jokers, posted by the Reddit user The Laser Shell. The idea behind this theory is that there is a master Joker. In Batman Year Zero, we see a young Bruce Wayne go up against the Red Hood gang, led by a criminal mastermind whose actual identity we never really learn. The theory is that the actual leader of the Red Hood gang hired a failed comedian to act as his double. He gets dropped into the chemicals, similar to what happens in the possible origin stories told in The Killing Joke. This person comes out insane as all hell, bleached white. Red Hood steps back, letting this new Joker take center stage. The third Joker is essentially the character of Johnny Frost from the Joker graphic novel, an army vet who gets a job as a low-level flunky to the mob. Bored of his life, he busts the second Joker out of jail, and he ends up getting shot. Once he recovers, he adopts the Joker's anarchist ways, emulating him while also becoming a more brutal version of him. Meanwhile, the original Joker is still out there behind the scenes. The basic idea of this theory is shared by many around the internet, just not in this exact way. Many believe that the three Jokers are merely that, three separate people that dress as clowns and fight against the Batman. Whether they know each other or not is unknown, or why they've never teamed up in the past is also unknown. Perhaps it's a mutual understanding that only one of them would be active in Gotham at a given time. Now, number two is another popular theory. The three Jokers are just versions of the Joker's broken psyche. The Joker's not a well man, I think we can all agree on that. Throughout his history, the Joker has been written in vastly different ways depending on the era of comics that you are reading from. Now, while this can be explained as simply changing of the times, Batman himself has been written just as differently throughout the ages of comics. The argument here is that because the Joker's sanity shifts, it allows him to actually perceive the changes in the style of comics, or the differences in reality. The Joker has been shown to remember things from different versions of his own past. Perhaps this is something akin to Deadpool's ability to break the fourth wall, but not as intense. With every crisis and reboot, the DC universe shifts in subtle ways, and it's possible that the Joker is aware of these shifts even as his own personality shifts subtly. Perhaps these shifts are what pushes his insanity deeper and deeper. Number three is that the three separate Jokers are from three separate universes. Now, this theory goes all the way back to the ending of Flashpoint in the beginning of New 52. When Barry Allen was trying to fix the timeline, he sees three timelines. He is then warned by a being that we would learn as Pandora that the world's history has already been broken into three separate timelines. The DC timeline has been separated several times, usually through a crisis event or something along the lines of Flashpoint. It's usually used when the DC canon has become bloated and the editors just want a soft reboot. Examples of this would be the New 52 or the post-crisis canon. So this theory suggests that each Joker is a version from these past timelines. The Killing Joke Joker is vastly different from the New 52 Joker, who himself has a different attitude from the Joker that existed prior to the New 52. As we recently learned, it was Dr. Manhattan that altered the DC Universe, not Barry Allen or the Flashpoint event, so it's possible something went wrong and these three Jokers are the side effect of this tampering. Now lastly, it's my theory, and my theory is somewhat of a riff-off of the literal three criminals who become the Joker theory. You see, the Joker is the epitome of evil.
It's epitome!
Epitome.
Epitome!
In Scott Snyder's run, Batman discovers that Gotham isn't the city that he always knew. There was a vein of evil that has run through the city since its very inception. This is shown through the Court of Owls, a secret society that has been quietly running everything for centuries, even aware of Bruce's nighttime excursions, but not really caring about it. During Endgame, it's also hinted that the Joker might have been around far longer than we originally thought. Like Pennywise the Clown from Stephen King's It, who Scott Snyder's a big fan of, by the way, Batman discovers evidence that a being known as the Pale Man has actually haunted Gotham for centuries. Now, Bruce discounts this as being false, and it is left up to the reader whether this is real or another ruse by the Joker to mess with his greatest adversary. But I think it's real. Possibly because I'm also a big fan of Stephen King. It's possible that these three separate Jokers are a physical embodiment of the evil that runs under Gotham, that the city itself twists and creates these individuals. The photos that Batman found weren't of the same Pale Man that returns throughout the centuries, but different Pale Men that were created. Gotham itself is evil and twists these people into an embodiment of that. What Batman doesn't know is that for the first time, there are three of them out there, three Pale Men out there at one time, and he'll have to deal with that now. If you guys enjoyed this and you want us to get some more theories or get together some of the more comic book community's overall theories about events, let us know in the comments down below. Give this video a like and don't forget to subscribe to Comic Storian to keep up to date in your current storylines and other things happening in the comic book universe. Thank you, and I'll see you next week.